Hello, in this video, I will be explaining this iceberg chart about the SAP Foundation that was made by the user Sefik Sapphire about a month ago in the rSAP forum. Now, do keep in mind that 20% of it are jokes while the rest are actually kind of real. So, if there's something I miss about it, please let me know in the comment so I could add more information to it. Now, let's dive down to this iceberg explanation. Non-standard object classes. It is referring to esoteric object classes that are used in the article outside of the most common ones, like Safe, Euclid, Kitter, and Tomil. An example of an esoteric or non-standard object class is Apollyon, Embla, Maxer, and many more. You can check this video to get an explanation of all object classes that are used in the articles. Things Dr. Bright isn't allowed to do. It is a list of rules in the wiki that has more than 200 rules that Dr. Brad isn't allowed to do while he was in the foundation. One example of the list is, Dr. Brad is not allowed to convince anyone to have a starring contest with SCP-096. Yeah, that kind of rules. Although the wiki article said it's not an actual depiction of how Dr. Brad acts or what actually is in the foundation, you can check the full list of rules, a link in the description. 294 is a Tomil. I can't think of the origin where this narration came from, but there's a Reddit post that discusses 294 being either Safe or Euclid. In my opinion, 294 is not classified as Tomil because it can't contain any SCPs. So I'm just gonna leave it to you guys. Group of interest. The foundation isn't the only one that is interested in anomalies. Some other groups or organizations also acknowledge anomalies and use it for their own benefit or goal. One example, such as the Global Occult Coalition that wanted to protect the world by destroying all anomalies in the world, or the Chaos Insurgency that rebels against the foundation and uses SCPs as a weapon against the foundation itself. There's currently more than 30 groups and you can read about it in the wiki. Scramble Goggle. As explained in the article about Incident 0961A, it is an equipment used by the Mobile Task Force Tau-1 Big Brother to scramble the face of SCP-096 so that they could negate the effect of 096. But sadly, it didn't function really well and caused lots of casualties. I will link the article in the description in case you guys wanted to read about the incident. The Original Fortune Threat. The first SCP ever made is the SCP-173 that was made in the Paranormal 4chan thread on the 22nd June 2007 and deleted days after. The original thread has been found back in 2018. It was created by USS Walrus and he said he'll post weekly SCP posts, but he had lost internet connection and forgot about the SCP Foundation for about a year later. The original text has changed over time, but the original concept is still the same. K-Class Scenario. Is a certain event or situation that could have a drastic effect on reality or the world itself. There's a lot of K-Class scenarios that are used in the wiki. The most common ones are the XK-Class Scenario or End of the World Scenario and ZK-Class Scenario or Reality Failure Scenario. And there's many more like Mass Extinction Scenario, Dominant Shift, and etc. Homophobic knockoff SCP website. I think it's referring to the RPC authority. It is basically the same thing as SCP Foundation, but it was created because of the 2018 drama about the whole LGB SCP stuff. I can't really explain it all because it's a long one, but I linked a Reddit post discussing this specific topic. Dash X entries. The X in the entry stands for explain. It is an SCP that is already figured out by the foundation and are no longer considered as an SCP because it has become a common thing or not an issue for the foundation itself. The most known X entry is the SCP-8900 Sky Blue Sky. It is a phenomenon that caused colors worldwide to be changed into a new one and already spread throughout the whole world, and the foundation just accepted it. Omega 7. It is referring to one of the Mobile Task Force group named MTF Omega 7 Pandora's Box, specializing on containment using cooperative SCPs like 076 and 105. But then it was disbanded by the foundation because of the breach that was caused by 076 going on a rampage, and the whole site is nuked to contain 076. Omega 7 disbanded after that incident, and you can read the incident report in the wiki. SCP-106 redesign. The original SCP-106 is changed because the lack of information regarding its copyright status of the original photo. Thus, the SCP-106 photography contest was held on the 8th of August 2018 to remove the old picture of 106 into a new one. I suggest you should watch Dr. Cimmerian's video on why 106 getting a redesign, and there's a contest for it. SCP-343 is actually a god. There are many to talk about it because it depends on how you take it and what headcanon that you're taking in this context. Because that's a lot of things we could talk about 343 itself. Some say 343 is a reality bender with god complex that really good at convincing people that he's god. There's a loose concept of being what is god throughout the community, and I can't quite confirm whether 343 is actually god or not. It depends on your belief in terms of canon. If you had any opinion regarding 343 is a god, please comment below. SCP-000. It is some sort of a hidden article in the Foundation where it tells a tale of an anomalous digital entity that lives beneath the Foundation's database. It tells that it is mostly space of nothingness with bits of data. He finds himself bored with his life and starts screaming to get Foundation's attention, which causes corruption towards the 000 entry, and the Foundation still isn't aware of the entity. Hidden text. It's like an Easter egg or something that is slipped inside an SCP article. Mostly, it has more detail or explanation about what actually going on in the article. For example, like the SCP-000 article, where you have to highlight the space to read the article. In 2163, you have to click a small button hidden below the article to reveal a hidden text. And also SCP-S, where you have to open up the page source to reveal hidden text that is laying around in the article. It is pretty interesting to know this kind of stuff that is left by the writer. I think it's a pretty interesting factor of the article itself. D-class is recycled. Once again, it depends on your headcanon. There's a canon where D-class personnel is terminated every month, and there's also a D-class that is recycled every time by the Foundation as their guinea pig until they are no longer usable. It is primarily because getting a D-class personnel is quite limited and termination only wastes a lot of resources, so yeah, that's true. SCP Containment Breach is an inside job. SCP Containment Breach is an SCP-based game that is created by Jonas Rikkonen, where you play as a D-class personnel escaping from the Foundation's facility where there's a containment breach, and lots of SCP is loose in the facility. To be frank, I don't know about this inside job thingy, so I can't really say much than just a normal breach that just happened in the game. Clearance Level 6. In the Foundation, as we all know, there's a clearance level for all personnel in the facility. Level 0 is for non-essential personnel that is non-secured area in the facility. Level 1 is for janitors. Level 2 is for staffs and agents. Level 3 is for senior staffs and agents. Level 4 is for site director and mobile task force commanders. And last is level 5 is held by the O5 council members. But there's also what is supposed to be a level 6 clearance in a few articles like Roger's proposal, where you have to input level 6 clearance to access the addendum. Or SCP-4023, where it says, "Does the Black Moon howl?" and reveals a level 6 confidential information. SCP-096 Survivor. As far as I researched about it, there are only a few people who survived the 096 attacks from the article Incident 096-1A, where the scramble goggles I mentioned before doesn't work really well and killed most of the mobile task force. And there are 4 people that survived the attack, one of which is Major Jack Wilford. He is the current commander of Mobile Task Force Tau 1, and the other survivor is currently unknown. 106 was a war criminal. The tale the young man tells the origin of SCP-106, which tells the story of Corporal Lawrence before he turned into our oozing humanoid SCP. And Lawrence was a World War I soldier. From the tale, I couldn't find what it seems to be an indication of a war crime done by 106 itself. But it is told that he had once killed his fellow bunkmates in a barbed wire with his insides scattered around the place, and also his sarge found in a toilet by a pack of rats killing him. So yeah, I guess it's kind of true. SCP-173 was a real sculpture. Yes, that is true, I guess. 173 statue was made by a Japanese artist Izumi Kato, and Izumi's son currently owns the real-life sculpture or statue of SCP-173 in his private collection. You can visit the artist's website to see all of his work on izumikato.com. But yeah, that's all I can say about this. Procedure 12 is Standard Protocol. Now, Procedure or Protocol 12 is an act that allows recruitment for D-class taken from other resources than death row inmates. These other resources are political prisoners, refugee populations, and other civilian sources. Now, this may be true because there isn't a lot of death row inmates according to the US government. So, this may be true that the Foundation indeed kidnapping people to be D-class since they gonna need a lot of them. Mimtic kill agents are real. Well, there isn't much to talk about this since Mimtic kill agents aren't real, if I say so to myself. It's just an amazing security countermeasure made by the Foundation itself to hunt down people that are trying to access an authorized document on the Foundation's database. If you wanted to see or experience how the Mimtic kill agents works, there's SCP-001 Pedantic Proposal Fishhook that explains how Berryman Langford Mimtic kill agent works. The origin of 106 original image. The original image was found randomly in the 4chat thread called Paranormal Thread. It was very unsure what it is or even who created the original picture of 106. Even the author itself says that he isn't sure about the picture that he found. That's why this whole 106 photo contest was held by the wiki itself to make 106 picture to be more official. Andre Duxin. Oh, where do we start? Andrei Duxin is a Russian person that has illegally registered an illegitimate trademark for SCP in Europe. He also committed copyright infringement towards SCP content that is protected by the Creative Commons license. And he also threatened the SCP community with lots of demands from the Russian wiki admin. You can read the whole problem here in the fundraising campaign, and you can see the update about this whole legal stuff that the SCP community is facing right now. SCP-012 is a 100 gag song. SCP-012 is supposed to be an unfinished composed song, that is, when it's played, it doesn't seem to be a song that you would like to hear in your everyday life. While 100 gags is an American duo artist that made some kind of hip-hop music that is questionable? I don't know who made this joke in the first place, but it seems we know what direction this joke is intended to be. Dr. Clef's face. Dr. Alto Clef is a department head division of training and development, one of the senior researchers in the Foundation. According to the file, Dr. Clef's face cannot be photographed in any way, but appears have to have a sizable nose and a grin resembling a Cheshire cat. There isn't any official image about Clef's face, but you can get a fan art representation of how Clef would look like. 0514. There isn't quite clear information regarding 0514 itself, and as far as I know, it is only mentioned once in the 001 Clef proposal at the end of the article that there's 0514 talking to the Foundation itself. It is currently unknown the whereabouts or any information about 0514 because there's only 0513 that serves as a tiebreaker when the 05 Council was founded with only 12 members. 049 Pestilence is dead itself. This is a popular theory made by the user on Reddit named Obviously Steve that explains the pestilence in 049's point of view is dead itself. It theorized that everyone is infected because everyone is dying more over time, and many people that he saw died from old age, like 049 saw Dr. Ham signs of aging like gray hair and wrinkles. And that's the reason why World 049 Resurrection is considered as a cure to beat death itself. You can read the whole discussion about what pestilence is for the 049 because it's a long and elaborate theory. 294 can cause a ZK class scenario. 294 is a coffee machine that could dispense anything that has a liquid form of a matter, like a cup of lava, a cup of gold, and etc. Well, ZK class scenario is an event where reality itself in this world is fundamentally broken because of an SCP. I don't think that I could find anything regarding this topic, nor even 294 itself could create a catastrophic event that could end reality itself. So if you guys had any idea about it, please let me know. Global Occult Coalition Woodchipper. It is mentioned in a 1609 article about a chair carved with some kind of a woman's head that can teleport and offer someone to sit on it. It is owned by the group of interest called Global Occult Coalition that tries to destroy it with a wood chipper that turns it into splinters and nails. Eventually, it started to teleport into people's lungs and suffocate everyone that tries to stop it. But then, it teleported to the foundation because the foundation is more of a content anomaly instead of destroying it.
Dr. Wondertainment is SCP Writers. Dr. Wondertainment is a group of interest that creates anomalous property in the shape or form of a children's toy. It is not known whether this is run by an individual, a collective group, or family descendants that holds the title of Dr. Wondertainment. I think this is some kind of a meta representation that SCP authors are Dr. Wondertainment because we or they made SCPs for the entertainment itself. So I guess this is where this narration came because we made all of the SCPs.
Dr. Bright Slam Dunk. I don't know what does this means or tells anything. I searched this stuff, maybe it's in one of the things that Dr. Bright isn't allowed to do, but I couldn't find anything related to this or what's so called slam dunk or basketball related. So if you guys know about this, please let me know in the comments.
Foreign branch with Hunnish language. Now, this is another thing that I don't know or couldn't find or I'm missing what kind of joke referring to this type. It is supposed to be a branch wiki page with Hunnish language or the language that is spoken by the Huns. I think it's some kind of joke made by the SCP community, but I don't really know about it.
Church of the Fixed God. It is referencing to the one of the group of interest called Church of the Broken God that worships Machane, the broken god or the god of machine, that they try to gather all the broken parts to fix the broken god itself to gain godhood powers. I can't tell what does the fix means, but I assume that is when Machane is fixed or reconstruct again, it will become Church of the Fixed God as the joke that is it's fixed now instead of broken. Or maybe not. So yeah. SCP-231 Uncensored. 231 is about 7 girls rescued from a satanic sex cult. 6 of them died, and there's only one left. Every time this girl gives birth, it will occur an event that could result in a massive loss of life when that happens. The article of 231 itself is heavily censored or redacted because of this classified event that not everyone should know about it. While there isn't an uncensored one with the official wiki itself, but there's still a discussion about 231 itself, like what happened after that and so on.
There is no SCP-001. Theoretically, on how you would see the 001 proposal, this could be true, because the sole purpose of the 001 proposal is to cover up the real 001 and to give all the employees sense of meaning of the article itself. It is also used by the Foundation as a decoy for someone that tries to access 001 documents and will be hunted down by the meme to kill agents. There has never been an official or real 001 according to the lore. So yeah, it's true.
Dr. Brand is GOW Spy. GOW, or Gamers Against Weed, is a loosely organized confederation of anomalous individuals that produce anomalous properties for the sake of satirical or entertainment purpose. Gamers Against Weed, in a nutshell, is basically a group of trolls that also acknowledge the existence of anomalies. I can't quite confirm that whether Brand is indeed a spy or not, but I can assume that this narration, because of the things that Dr. Brand isn't allowed to do, Oracle as a reflection of this group of interest itself. Maybe I was wrong, but feel free to add some more information. RPC Authority is Chaos Insurgency. RPC Authority is kind of the same as SCP Foundation because it was meant to be like SCP 2.0, but they were more into research, while Chaos Insurgency was to rebel out the SCP Foundation or using the SCPs as a weapon against the Foundation. I think what this narration goes to that it is because of the drama back in 2018 where most of the auras and content creator moved and created a new organization, just like Chaos Insurgency moved from the Foundation to create a new one. It has some kind of meta similarities towards the conflict that both RPC and SCP had with the SCP and the Chaos Insurgency had. Majora's Mask is a cover-up for SCP-035. Majora's Mask is an item from the game series called The Legend of Zelda. When it's equipped, the mask has the ability to bestow an evil and wicked power upon its wearer, and it tells that it influenced Skull Kids, one of the game characters, to steal it. Well, SCP-035 is a mask that when someone wears it, it will take control of the wearer's body and it will decay due to corrosion came from the 035 itself. I guess it kind of resembles the idea of a mask and could grieve or control the wearer itself, some kind of power. I don't really know about this one, and there isn't much stuff I could find between two of these things. SCP Secret Laboratory is a training program. It's basically a game like SCP Containment Breach where you play as a character and then run away from the facility itself, but it has a twist because this is a multiplayer game and you can play as a D-class, researcher, SCP, and etc., which they have their own goal to finish the game. I don't think it's a training program because in the game itself that breach just happened and we need to get out quickly and even destroy the facility with an auto warhead or nuking the facility. I don't think that a training program would that be as far as I concern about it, so yeah, it's an interesting concept. Series 0. SCP has a series. Currently, as I'm making this video, there are 6 series available for us to read. Series 1 from 001 to 999, Series 2 from 1000 to 1999, and so on. I think what is Series 0 is referring that this would be an SCP series before Series 1 itself, but I can't really find anything related to Series 0. There is Incident Zero Tale, but I don't think that's what it's referring to. The O6 Council. I can't find anything related to O6 Council, but there was a discussion made by a Reddit post about O6 Council. Basically, it's just the same thing as level 6 clearance, but higher than O5 itself. It is theorized to be the administrator itself or a selected person, maybe like Dr. Ike or Dr. Nakayama, that could access the forbidden file for level 6 clearance only in the 4023 article. It is still a mystery, but I think this is the far as I can search about it. SCP-500 Recover Lost Foreskin. SCP-500 is a pill that can instantly cure any disease by the user, and it has been tested with various extreme diseases like 008, but I don't know who made this kind of joke in the first place, or maybe the creator of this iceberg itself, but it kind of tells that SCP-500 could restore foreskin after being... yeah, dead. But why would you do that in the first place though? The Chaos Insurgency is the good guys. Now, this is very dependent on how you guys will see the lore itself. You could say Chaos Insurgency is good, the Global Occult Coalition is good, and many more, because there is no canon, so feel free to theorize. But I would say Chaos Insurgency kind of a good guy because they're made up of people who wanted to bring down an organization, tasked with defending humanity, and weaponize SCPs, or the Oracle like Cactus Insurgent, which is an interesting side from Chaos Insurgency, but then it is based on your perspective because there was no good or bad side in this universe. I suggest you guys read the Foundation and Evil article made by Dr. Clef itself. 106 Pocket Dimension is Brazil. Pocket Dimension is a place where you were put inside by the 106 as if you were its prey. Currently, 106 Pocket Dimension is described as halls and rooms with unknown substances, and it is believed to be like a labyrinth-like structure. It is supposed to be like those "you are going to Brazil" meme, where you were pulled off to Brazil forcefully as if Brazil is an undesirable place or hell itself, like the Pocket Dimension. I think it's pretty good meme. All tales are canon. This is solely based on your preferences, because in the frequently asked question page in the wiki article, it said that SCP Foundation is made on contradiction itself, and there are many canons you could read. If you believe a certain tale and you keep it as your belief, like 682 is dead, then it's a canon. If you read a tale about 343 is God and the Clef proposal is Uriel and believe it in your will, then it's canon. So, theoretically, every tale is canon if you take everything is to be true. Homestuck is about SCP-093. Homestuck is a webcomic series that is made by American artist Andrew Hussey. And 093 is about a red disc covered in a cinnabar with symbols, and it could create a portal to an alternate world where a godlike being create a technological catastrophe in mid-90s. I can't think, or it may be kind of similar, because both scenarios had some sort of apocalyptic scenario in their field, but it could be just coincidence. If there's a Homestuck fan that could explain it better than me, but there is one SCP that kind of relates to Homestuck, and that is SCP-2721 that explains an entity that orbits around the moon. The J-Page is Foundation cover-up. J-Page is referring to the joke SCP library that is available for everyone to read. It is essentially the same as any SCP article, but it's a joke or just for the fun article. Like 789J, the Butt Ghost, or Sumerian Cactus Proposal, the Broke God, where it has a funny and elaborate joke in the format of an SCP article. Now, this is based on your perspective as well, because it could be indeed a cover-up made by the Foundation to think that this whole SCP Foundation is fictional and too stupid to be real. Just like the SCP-010 France, where the Foundation site itself is an SCP and it makes everyone thought something so confidential like this couldn't be given away on the internet, so everyone thought it was just a fiction. So yeah, it's a good meme. Sarki cult or Catholics. Sarki cult is one of the group of interest based on philosophy or religious system with lots of tradition, belief, and spiritual practices around the world that worship the god of flesh or Yaldabaoth, the opposite of Church of the Broken God group. Now, there isn't much to say about this because there were no confirmation whether the Sarki cult is Catholics, but it is a popular belief that Catholics is always considered or always linked to a cult in many places around the world that does some weird ritual or religious stuff, worshipping some kind of deity that is kind of the same like what the Sarki cult does. So yeah, I can say for sure for this one. 096 related to 106. As you guys know, 096 is a shy guy SCP where you shouldn't see his face because you will be targeted by him till you're dead, while 106 itself is the old man that could cause some kind of corrosion or decay everything that he touches and puts people in his pocket dimension. I can't find any reference regarding both of them being together. The young man tells the story of 106 from the World War I era before he became an anomalous entity, and there isn't much to say about the origin of 096 itself. SCP Foundation as a cover-up. This may be referring to the real-life cover-up by the government or some organization to hide the abnormalities that are happening around the world by creating some sort of an elaborate sci-fi writing community, like the SCP Foundation, just as exactly like SCP-101 France. Well, all Foundation database is leaked throughout the internet as the SCP Wiki, and everyone believe it to be just as a sci-fi community. But I don't think that it will be a good idea for this secret organization to cover up something by running a community that has run over a decade. SCP-2700's YK class already happened. SCP-2700 is a directed energy weapon created by the famous Nikola Tesla. Imagine it like a super doomsday weapon made by Tesla itself, and the Foundation's objective when retrieving the object is to deactivate it before the YK class event happens. YK class is a scenario which is the end of a universe. 2700 is about Tesla working together with another person from another universe to create this invention. Later, it was taken by this person to destroy another universe. Tesla then brought the device back and desired to destroy our current universe. And sadly, I don't have any evidence that this YK class already happened because the Foundation already confiscates the device. So yeah, it didn't happen. Dr. Wondertainment is an inside jump for the Foundation to allocate more international government funding. This is another thing I couldn't find or theorize about it, because there wouldn't be any reason why the Foundation creates Dr. Wondertainment just to fund some organization. After all, that's the opposite what the Foundation should do. In fact, the Foundation had fund companies to fund themselves, like the Spicy Crust Pizzeria or Standard Computer Products, and many more fund companies that helps Foundation. So yeah, I can say for sure for this one. You are an SCP. Well, this may be true because the Foundation itself sees anomalies as a normal thing for them to see, while normal people like us probably seen as a different being. Just like the O513 case, where he's just a normal person amongst the O5 council. But because of the O51 till O512 had some anomalous traits and properties, then O513 seen as an anomaly because he's different than the others and considered as an SCP. Using this logic, then we maybe are an SCP to them. SCP-173 and Dr. Clef's sex tape. When it says do not research, they do really mean it, because it's really... Yeah, it came from the tale called Date Night from the LOL Foundation canon, where... Yeah, Dr. Clef literally had a dinner date with SCP-173 while five other D-classes making eye contact towards 173 itself to not make it move. It all started just like a normal dinner date, but then... Yeah, it gets a little heated, I'd say. I don't want to explain it to you guys because it ruins the whole feeling of the tale itself. I'll link the tale in the description and see it for yourself, but yeah, it's 100% real. SCP-106 is based on a Lovecraftian deity. It is to be rumored that 106 appearance concept is inspired by H.P. Lovecraft deity called Nyarlathotep, which is described as the black man from the H.P. Lovecraft stories called The Dreams in the Witch House. It has a similar appearance from the look itself, like the blackness, the body, and the look itself is really kind of similar to Nyarlathotep. But it was never confirmed that it's inspired or based on Nyarlathotep, just the similarities that were being shared between these two characters. Herobrine is SCP-001. No. Just... no. Herobrine is just an urban legend or creepypasta back in the early 2013 that messed up players' world in the game of Minecraft. No 001 proposal are referring to this entity whatsoever, so I'm sure to myself that it's not considered as 001. Dr. Bright's arch nemesis, Dr. Dark. Dr. Jack Bright is one of the senior researchers for the Foundation and also a personal director for several sites in the Foundation. I think it's a reverse model kind of joke where Dark is the opposite of Bright itself, because I couldn't find any information regarding this Dr. Dark, but I only found Mr. Dark from the Marshall, Carter, and Dark group of interest, but there's no information regarding between Dr. Bright and Mr. Dark.
So you made it to the end. So yeah, that's my explanation about this iceberg meme. Maybe I missed something or some details about one of the topics given above. So if I do, please comment down below so I could add more information later in the comment. And I hope you guys enjoy it and leave a like if you really really like it, because it helps me so much. And I'll see you guys later. Goodbye.